ओके, आई स्टार्टेड रिकॉर्डिंग इट। सो विंटर 20 वेरिएंट 11, व्हिच स्टेटमेंट इज करेक्ट? क्लोरीन हैज रिलेटिव एटॉमिक मास 35। रॉन्ग, बिकॉज दिस इज द रिलेटिव एटॉमिक मास। रिलेटिव आइसोटोपिक मास इज द पर्टिकुलर मास ऑफ द पर्टिकुलर आइसोटोप व्हिच इज नॉट 35.5। क्लोरीन हैज रिलेटिव मॉलिक्यूलर मास 70। रॉन्ग, क्लोरीन हैज रिलेटिव मॉलिक्यूलर मास 71। अच्छा, NaCl हैज रिलेटिव मॉलिक्यूलर मास 58.5। रॉन्ग, बिकॉज दिस इज द फॉर्मूला मास। NaCl हैज आयोनिक कंपाउंड। फॉर आयोनिक कंपाउंड वी कैन नॉट यूज द वर्ड रिलेटिव मॉलिक्यूलर मास। सो सी इज द आंसर। ओके, रिलेटिव मॉलिक्यूलर मास, ICl इज अ मॉलिक्यूल, एंड इफ यू एड द एटॉमिक मास ऑफ क्लोरीन एंड आयोडीन इट विल बी 162.4। ओके, सो वन सी टू चले। ओके, आई कैन डू इट। स्ट्रॉन्शियम, स्ट्रॉन्शियम एटॉमिक मास, वन सेकेंड। ओके, नाउ वी कैन सिंप्लीफाई इट। क्वेश्चन इज अबाउट दिस वन एंड दिस वन, फॉरगेट अबाउट दिस टू। सिक्स मोल, थ्री मोल, वी कैन सिंप्लीफाई इट। वन मोल, दिस इज टू मोल। ओके, अंडरस्टैंड? एंड वी कैन मोर सिंप्लीफाई इट। इफ इट इज वन मोल मीन्स दिस इज 0.5 मोल। Okay, you are given the mass of strontium oxide. Okay, SRO and SR. 1 mole, 0.5 mole, according to equation. What is the AR of strontium? 87.6 plus 16. That is the MR. 87.6 plus 16, 103.6 gram. And this is strontium is 87.6 divided by 2. 0.6 divided by 2, 43.8 gram. आई मीन 0.5 मोल है ना, इसलिए 1 मोल दिस एंड 0.5 मोल दिस, सो रेशियो इज 1:1/2। हियर इट इज हाफ। ओके, सो द क्वेश्चन 103.6 ग्राम गिव्स 43.8 ग्राम। सो इफ इट इज 100 ग्राम दिस विल बी एक्स। So cross multiply, so answer will be 42.3 gram. Okay. Okay. Another way you convert, look again, there's another way you convert. Achha, this is 3. Forget about these two because it's about 100 gram strontium oxide produces how many gram of strontium? Mass of strontium. First find mole-mole relationship. This is 1, this is 0.5, because this is 1, this is 2, right? So 2 mole strontium oxide, 1 mole strontium. So 100 gram of strontium oxide, so mass upon MR, 87.6 plus 16. So this is the second method. Whatever the mass given, convert into mole. So 100 upon this is the MR of strontium oxide, 0.96 mole strontium oxide. According to equation, 2 mole strontium oxide, 1 mole strontium, 0.48 mole strontium. Okay. Okay. Roughly, because I have rounded it off. So you have to find mass of strontium. Mass is equal to AR into mole. AR is 87.6 into mole 0.48. मैंने इसको थोड़ा सा राउंड ऑफ कर दिया इसलिए. सो आंसर विल बी क्लोज टू 42.1. सो इट्स क्लोज टू दिस. इफ आई डोंट राउंड ऑफ दिस वन देन आंसर विल बी वेरी क्लोज टू बी. ओके गॉट इट. अच्छा नाउ क्वेश्चन 3. अकॉर्डिंग टू एग्जामिनर रिपोर्ट however it was very simple question, but according to examiner report that many students made mistake here. Pade, a single phosphorus 32 can be produced, it means it is in product side, when a single s2 nucleus, s means phosphorus, keep in mind that sulfur has atomic number 16, phosphorus has atomic number 15. When S joins X, this is formed. In this process, a proton is emitted. One proton is emitted. Okay. So 16 minus 1 is 15 because one proton is lost. So the atomic number is 15 now. But the mass number should also be decreased, right? But the mass number is again 32. So it means which particle is X? Yes, a deuteron, electron is wrong because if it is electron is added, it should be minus charge here. Proton. If we add one proton, then atomic number should be 17. So this is also wrong. So answer is neutron. Sulfur, if it adds neutron, neutron means mass number 1. Phosphorus plus proton. So sulfur lost one proton means phosphorus is formed because its atomic number is 15. 32 plus 1, 33. Okay. This is 32, or proton has one mass, 33. So it is balanced, right? Achha ji. Khizr Ali, kaun hai bhai? Yes, question number 4. In liquid, are there only intermolecular forces based on temporary dipole? Ethanol has hydrogen bonding also. So wrong. Hydrogen chloride has permanent dipole. Wrong. Water has hydrogen bonding, wrong. So answer is bromine because it is non-polar. It has only intermolecular forces, temporary dipole. Keep in mind temporary dipole, very important point. Temporary dipole is present in all the molecules. Whether it is permanent, it is present in HCl also, ethanol also, water also. But it's written only. Okay, huh? Temporary dipole is a major intermolecular force in non-polar molecules. Okay. Okay, next. So, MCQ number 5. Copper has high melting point. Why? What is the reason? This is very simple. I think you have done in O level. Yes. Strong attractive between copper atom only? Wrong. In metals, we have metallic bond. Strong attractive between copper ions only? Wrong. Strong attractive proposed between copper atom and dislocalized electron? Wrong. Between copper ions, because we know in metals have free mobile electrons. And the positive ions. So attraction between, this is the metallic bond. See, which pair of standard changes are numerically equal that we discuss in energetics chapter? This one. Why? Because carbon, burning of carbon in the form of graphite, this is enthalpy change of combustion of carbon in the form of graphite. And you can also say it is the enthalpy change of formation of carbon dioxide. Okay. Atomization of methane is different. Atomization of methane means if you break methane into atoms, while formation means from its element in the standard form, which is why it is wrong. Combustion of methanol and combustion of graphite and hydrogen is different. Okay. Achha. Neutralization of HCl and NOH and formation of water are different. Neutralization is from acid and base. This is neutralization. Okay. And formation of water is from elements. This is the formation of water. And this is neutralization. Different. Okay. MCQ number 7 is little conceptual. Please start your, is based on Hess's law. Very simple. Standard enthalpy change of formation of Br minus 31001. So this is standard enthalpy change of formation. But it's for 2 mole. So multiply 2 into minus 301 is equal to minus 602. Enthalpy change bromine trifluoride liquid to bromine trifluoride gas is 44. This one. But this is for 2 mole, it will be 2 into 44. अच्छा जी, अच्छा अच्छा समवन वाज मेकिंग this one. Now, okay, what is the average bond energy of BrF? BrF3 को आपने you broken down. तो इसमें कितने बॉन्ड टूट रहे हैं देखें. This is bromine trifluoride. 1, 2, 3 bond. And if it is 2, it means 6 bond. So 6 BrF bond is broken down. Okay. So if you apply Hess's law, go this way and go this way, it will be same. 698 is equal to this way means minus 602 plus 88 plus 6x. So you have to find average bond energy of BRF means first you find for 6 BRF bond and then for 1. So the answer will be 202. Understand any confusion? Based on Hess's law. Hurry up. Okay. Read the question again. In which reaction does the greatest change in the oxidation number of sulfur occur? Because it's easier, so I will go very fast, quickly. A is the answer because 0, 2, plus 4. Sulfur dioxide means sulfur is plus 4, it is plus 6. It is plus 6, plus 6. Here also it is plus 6. Plus 6 and plus 6. Better to save your time, you remember sulfur trioxide, sulfur is plus 6, sulfuric acid, sulfur is plus 6. And in H2S2O7 also sulfur is plus 6. Okay. So sulfur dioxide you have plus 4, sulfur you have 0. 0 to plus 4 is the greatest change. Okay. Number 9. Again, redox. What is reduced in this reaction? Listen. Shortcut. Oxygen oxidation number does not change unless if it is peroxide or some peroxide. Then oxygen oxidation number is changed, or OF2 is the exceptional compound, or some superoxide. It is not there. So oxygen is wrong. Hydrogen is not there. Carbon is 0. Here carbon is plus 4. Here carbon is plus 2. So carbon is 0 to plus 2 means oxidation wrong. Let's see chlorine. In molecular form it is 0. In chlorine minus 1, 4 chlorine minus 4, titanium is plus 4. Yes, 0 to minus 1. 0 to minus 1. Yes, it is reducing, so it means chlorine is the answer. Oxidation number decreasing means reduction. Titanium is wrong because titanium is plus 4 here also. Titanium is plus 4 here. It's no change. Got it? Question number 10 was very tricky. I give you a few seconds to do it. So you should have at equilibrium, which is not mentioned, but this should be at equilibrium. So initial mole of HSO4 minus was 2. Why? Because sulfuric acid was 2. 2 mole per diem of, and it goes to completion means this is also 2 and this is also 2 mole per diem cube. But this is not reversible reaction. This is a reversible reaction. It means you got HSO4 minus. Initial. How much was the change? Because you are given the equilibrium mole. Equilibrium mole is 1.988. It means 2 minus 1.988, 0.012 mole is the change. Ratio is same. This should also be 0.012, right? Achha, this is abhi reaction starting one. This should also be 0.012 at least. हार्ट अच्छे 90% स्टूडेंट्स हु डोंट रीड द क्वेश्चन केयरफुली लाइक आई डिड आई ऑल्सो डिड द सेम मिस्टेक. हाइड्रोजन वॉज 2 mole per dm³ इनिशियली. ओके सो एट इक्विलिब्रियम दिस इज 0.012 दिस इज 2+0.012. वो व्हाई बिकॉज हाइड्रोजन वॉज ऑल्सो 2 mole इनिशियली. व्हेन सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड वॉज 2 दिस वॉज ऑल्सो 2 दिस ऑल्सो 2. ओके देन दिस HSO4 starting it was 2 and this was 2 already initially. Then from HSO4 also dissociated partially and at equilibrium it was this one 1.988. So the change is 0.012. it means 0.012 mole produced from HSO4 minus and 2 it was produced from sulfuric acid. Okay, that was my mistake also, that when I did first time I ignored this too, and that most of my students also did the same mistake. Okay, now you will see KC is product upon reactant. So 0.012 2 plus 0.012 is, yes, 2.012 divided by 1.988. So the answer will be, I think, C is the answer. Okay. I remember. Yes. Achha, this is autocatalytic reaction. One usually is not, students ignore this. Autocatalytic reaction you study in chapter 8, chemical kinetics. It's a reaction in which product becomes catalyst. Product formed becomes catalyst. So the rate initially was slower and then become faster. A and B is wrong, because the rate becomes faster, rate never remains constant. D is also wrong, because rate is decreasing. C is the answer. You see, reaction was going this way, suddenly become faster and then decreasing. Why decreasing? Because obviously reactants consume. So it is the repeated question in 20 years. I think it is the third time they have asked this question. Okay, so autocatalytic reaction is the reaction in which the product becomes constant. C is the answer. D. X and Y are two elements in the period 3. Period 3, which are the elements? I write here. Aluminum, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, argon. Okay. X forms soluble acidic oxide. It means S can be phosphorus or sulfur. Okay. Actually, the oxidation number of X in the oxide is +4. Suppose we assume sulfur, because these two are the oxide in acidic oxide. Sulfur dioxide +4. It is possible. Phosphorus does not have +4. So X is suppose sulfur. Y forms amphoteric oxide. So there is only one which forms aluminum. So Y is aluminum. amphoteric oxide. Aluminum is in group 13, earlier group 3, and sulfur is in group 16, and earlier it used to be called group 6, minus 2 charge. So what should be the formula? Al2S3. Okay. Achha. Okay, guys. Number 13. Group 2 question. Which statement applies? Question is takes time to send two element of group 2. Suppose beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium. Radium is also there, but usually they don't ask about radium. Three of the statements shown are correct for metal Q. One remaining statement is correct for metal R. A saturated solution of hydroxide of this metal has a higher pH value. Again, it is not possible for these three metals. This is only possible for barium hydroxide, which is readily soluble. Means niche wala koi ek. Barium. Barium hydroxide is soluble. This is hydroxide not soluble, magnesium hydroxide not soluble, competitive calcium also not soluble. This metal has a carbonate that is used in agriculture to reduce the acidity of soil. Okay, you usually use calcium carbonate. Okay. Suppose R is calcium carbonate. This metal has a greater atomic radius, so barium has a greater atomic radius. This metal reacts more quickly with cold water, barium down the group, reactivity increases. So this point and this point, this is for Q. And this metal is a carbonate that is, we don't use barium carbonate, barium is toxic, okay. Calcium carbonate. So B is the answer. Which statement to R? R has only one property, calcium carbonate. Okay. Okay. Electronic configuration. I will go quickly because it's easier. Oxidizing agent. You have studied in which chapter? In halogen, fluorine is the strongest oxidizing agent, then chlorine, then bromine, then iodine. So fluorine atomic number is 9, 1s2, 2s2, 2p5. A is the answer. Okay, fluorine. This is magnesium. This is 3P5 means 17 chlorine, and this is 3P6 plus 2. This is calcium. So fluorine is A is the answer. Group 2 again. Group 2 ke do question aa gaye. The second question. How many X cube produce a white solid product? Calcium plus water, calcium hydroxide, this is white, is partially soluble, so PPT is formed. Barium chloride plus strontium hydroxide, barium hydroxide is formed, which is soluble in water. Suppose if this chlorides are soluble, so no. This is white solid form. Calcium carbonate plus hydrochloric acid, calcium chloride, which is soluble. No, no white solid. मैग्नीशियम सल्फेट प्लस बैरियम नाइट्रेट, यस वी नो बैरियम सल्फेट प्लस मैग्नीशियम नाइट्रेट, दिस इज वाइट सॉलिड, दिस इज वाइट सॉलिड, टू टू वाइट सॉलिड प्रोड्यूस अ वाइट सॉलिड प्रोडक्ट. सो कैल्शियम हाइड्रोक्साइड वाइट सॉलिड, बैरियम सल्फेट वाइट सॉलिड, these two are not soluble. Group 1, group 2 compounds are usually white in if they are solid form. Okay, so two of the compounds are not soluble. So see the questions. This question number 13 was also very twisted question. I mean, to read, if you read it, so you have to be very thorough. Question 16, halogen, and this is a repeated question. Group 17. Okay. Which, see the bold word, when is a bold word first circulate? And as strong acid and oxidizing agent. Keep in mind, carbonate plus acid. Base plus acid, hydrogen carbonate, write this rule, plus acid and precipitation, double displacement reaction, these are never redox, never redox. Carbonate acid, base acid, hydrogen carbonate acid, base acid or alkali plus acid and precipitation reaction are never redox. Okay, so this is wrong. Potassium chloride and sulfur trioxide plus sulfuric question is which compound does the concentrated sulfuric act? This is also wrong. Sulfur trioxide plus acid is H2S2O7. I told you to memorize, all of them have plus 6 oxidation state, plus 6. If there is no change in oxidation state, C is the answer, not chloride. Why? Because potassium chloride plus sulfuric acid, if you remember, HCl form, -1, -1, no change in oxidation state. Potassium hydrogen sulfate or potassium sulfate, both are possible, but sulfur oxidation state is not changed. Please memorize that sulfur has plus 6 in S. It will save your time. SO3, H2S2O4, H2S2O7, hydrogen sulfate, in all of them sulfur is plus 6. It saves your time. So there is no change in oxidation state. It means sulfuric acid is not acting as reduce oxidizing agent. Sulfuric acid acts as oxidizing agent with bromide, iodide and acetate. Yeah, keep in mind, just write it down. Not with fluoride and chloride. Because reducing power is opposite. Reducing power, iodide, then bromide, then chloride, then fluoride. So these two are the weak reducing agent. So concentrated sulfuric acid is an oxidizing agent, but it can act with these two, not with these two. Okay. Ammonia can undergo acid-base reaction with hydrogen chloride to form ammonium chloride. Again, I ask my student to remember ammonia and ammonia. Ammonia, NH3, you have seen, this is a lone pair. It forms a dative bond. Now, nitrogen, ammonia can form hydrogen bond, but not ammonium, because the lone pair is not available. Which statement is correct? Ammonium ion, this is a base. After accepting proton, it forms conjugate acid. can give H plus ion back. Ammonium ion is basic wrong. Hydrogen atom from HCl, donates a lone pair of electron to nitrogen atom, wrong. Nitrogen atom donates lone pair to H plus. The NH bonding in ammonia is same in ammonium, bilkul galat. Kyunki yahan three pairs, one lone pair. Here four bond pair in ammonium. So D will be the answer, obviously. The NH bond angle in ammonium ion is same as the carbon in methane. Yes, because both have four bond. Four bond pair mean 190.5 degree. So D is the answer. 18. Oh my God, this is a third group two question. Very easy. Think, I give you a few seconds. First ionization energy decreases down the group because atomic radius increases, so less energy is required. Decreases is B, decreases is B. Either B is correct or D is correct. Okay. Now, thermal stability, what happens? Thermal stability of compounds of group 2 down the group increases. Thermal stability increases means more temperature is needed to break the compound. Okay? D is the answer. Sulfur dioxide reacts with this time unexpectedly they have more questions from inorganic number. I think the examiner was a little lenient because of corona. I think inorganic sulfur dioxide plus calcium hydroxide. Initially they form calcium sulfide plus water. C is the answer. Then further oxidation with more oxygen and sulfur dioxide it form calcium sulfate. First calcium sulfide is formed. Okay. Oh my God. Question 20. Compound XYZ are shown. How many other isomers? Achha, you have to consider stereo and structure. Okay. So C3H7ClO, one possibility is this. Both chlorine and OH are on one carbon. This is X, and X and Y are mirror images. Second possibility, chlorine and OH both are on the second carbon. There is no chiral carbon here. This is Z. Apart from these two, they ask how many other compounds. Okay, I'm drawing the other now. So both chlorine and OH on first carbon, one possibility. Both chlorine and OH are on second carbon, second possibility. We want to make other. Okay. So what is the third possibility? OH on first carbon, chlorine on second carbon. So this carbon has optical isomers. So it has two. Chiral carbon, it will have two. Now, second possibility. Vice versa. What vice versa? I mean, chlorine on this carbon, OH on this carbon. Okay, this carbon is chiral. Again, two possibility, optical isomers. Okay, optical isomers, optical. Because of the chiral carbon, optical isomer. Third possibility. mirror images, I mean. One more possibility is there that OH is on first and chlorine is on the last. Now there is no chiral carbon. So when a question says structure plus stereo, when you are considering the stereo, you don't count the structure because it will be, the structure will be any one of them. So how many possibilities are there? Five. One, two, three, four, and this five. Got it? Okay. Understand? So one OH on two optical isomers here. Two optical isomers here because this is a chiral carbon and there is no chiral carbon, so one is here. Two, two, four, and one, five. D is the answer. Okay. 21. Two students makes it. Student one, two methyl butanine has geometrical isomer. Let's make 1, 2, 3, 4. Two methyl. No need to satisfy the hydrogen. Butanine. Oneine means it has two hydrogen. When the double bonded carbon has two hydrogen, it will never have cis trans isomer. Student one is wrong. Which are correct? This is wrong. This is wrong. Okay, let's see. Student two are correct or wrong. Two methyl butanine, I mean same. Reacts with HBr. That's it. HBr. In an addition reaction to give 1-bromo-2-methyl-butane as the main product, H will go to the carbon which has more hydrogen for major product, and Br will be on the second carbon, right? So 1-bromo-2-methyl-butane is the major product. Wrong. This is the major product. 2-bromo-2-methyl-butane is the major product. 2-bromo-2-methyl-butane is the major product because hydrogen goes to that carbon which has relatively higher number of hydrogen atoms. So 2 is also wrong. D is the answer. Okay. Which statement is correct when referring to the complete combustion of PVC? Complete combustion of PVC means, God, it was not resumed. Sorry. From where we lost? Just, I tell you the answer from here, right? Just tell you the answer. Because this is correct, this is wrong. Lowering the temperature has nothing to do with the half answer is correct, but forward reaction is exothermic. It has nothing to do with the exo or endo. Pressure also has nothing to do with the number of moles. When you increase the pressure, rate of reaction increases. Okay. So this one, 35, was easier because I could not record it. This is correct. Sodium has, this is correct. This is wrong because silicon has more electrical conductivity. Okay, the 35, 1 and 2. 36, sodium chloride in pH is 7. Yes, correct. Silicon chloride form HCl in water, so its pH may be 0 to 2. Is correct. Aluminum chloride also form HCl in water. Its pH is 0 to 2. Yes, all three correct. A answer. 37, C5H8O3, this MR is 60 plus 8 plus 48, 116, one is correct. Two group that shows strong absorption between this one and this one, both have strong observation. This is correct. It's only infrared absorption. This is for OH group, but it's not only. It's not only. This also has sharp. So three is wrong. Okay, one MCQ only. It will take time to explain. So 38 I'm giving you. You should solve and send me. 39. I have only 1 minute left. Which reactions give water as one of the product? Reaction with primary alcohol. These reactions are primary level. Reaction with ethanoic acid form ester and water, yes. Reaction with concentrated HBr, yes. Because any alcohol plus HBr, water plus substitution reaction, yes, water is formed. Passing alcohol vapor over aluminum oxide is dehydrating agent, yes. Alcohol, primary alcohol, if it is alcohol, aluminum oxide, alkene, plus water, dehydration takes place. Yes, water is all three correct. Okay. A. Last one is, this one is, you know, which reagents polymer X react with? Aqueous sulfuric acid. It has ester. Ester can be reacted with sulfuric acid. Yeah, dilute, yes. Ester can react with NaOH, yes. Ester does not react with sodium. Sodium reacts with alcohol and OH group, like carboxylic or alcohol. No OH, so no, it means B is the answer. Okay, thank you very much. Okay.